matter of moments, right here on the Sports Network, you will see Rick Martel take on Mr. Saito before they go to the arena, before they fight for the heavyweight championship of the world. We have a chance to talk to them, and first of all, I want to bring in the heavyweight champion of the world, Rick Martel. Rick, you got a tough one.
Oh, Larry, you know, I just heard one of the Freebirds, Buddy Roberts, saying he was ashamed. He's from Canada and he's ashamed of it. Well, I'm from Canada and I'm proud of it. And Buddy Roberts, if you want to argue about it, here I am. Now, you know, I was scheduled to wrestle the superstar, the mass superstar for the World Championship. And all of a sudden, he couldn't make it, and they throw Saito at me. When I was trained, I was ready for the mass superstar, and now I got Saito. All of a sudden, the last-minute thing. And Saito's been waiting for the opportunity for a long time. I know he's been training hard for it. He knew his time was going to come up. And, you know, I beat Jumbo Tsuruta from Japan. And this man knows that if he can beat me for the world title, he'll come back to Japan as a hero. When I want this belt to stay right here in Canada, I'm from Canada, I'm proud of it, as I said. And I'm a Canadian champion, and people here in Canada are behind me. And you know, I'm very happy. I feel real good about this match being here, right here in Canada, in my backyard.
All right, one problem. You prepared for Superstar, and you've got Saito. Let's talk about another problem. You're on the road constantly. Are you tired?
I know, you know, the schedule is very hard, and it's hard to train hard. It's hard to train right, to diet right for it. But, you know, when you come out of that ring still holding the World Championship, it's worth every minute of it. Thank you.
Rick Martel, the heavyweight champion of the world, and he'll be defending that title against this man, Mr. Saito.
Hey.
This is your chance, the biggest chance any wrestler in the world can ever have, your shot at the world's heavyweight title.
You know what, Ricky Martel, he's so lucky man. He beat Jumbo Tsuruta. But he lucky. You know, Japanese are mad strong. Now, I challenge you. I'm not Jumbo Tsuruta. I'm a tough. I'm a mean. Montero, you're a Canadian wrestler. Too soft. I beat so easy now. I take grubby belt. I beat you. I walk the home. My people so love it. Emperor Hirohito so loved me. Montero-san.
You didn't know until a short time ago that you were going to get this title shot. Have you had a chance to prepare to wrestle Rick Martel for the heavyweight championship of the world?
Ha! Kundatara itsudemo koi, Montero. I am Mr. Saito, Mr. Toja. I destroy it to you. Maybe I grab your legs. I grab your arms. Grab your chest. Ha! I mean so to you, Montero. Kundatara koi itsudemo. Me, Hana. Menya me hanya hao, kundatara karadu yatukeru. Me, kushi, Martel.
They're on their way to the arena, and it's going to be a great one, Rick Martel and Mr. Saito.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this bout, one fall, 60-minute time limit for the heavyweight championship of the world. Your referee, Joe Fiorino. Introducing first the challenger. He weighed in at 249 pounds out of Tokyo, Japan. He is Mr. Torture, Mr. Saito. And his opponent at 238 pounds out of Quebec City, Canada. He is the heavyweight champion of the world, Ricky Martel. Down the ringside.
Thank you, Ken Resnick. The heavyweight champion of the world, Rick Martel. And he's got his title on the line against a very dangerous man, Mr. Saito. We know both these wrestlers very, very well. Nobody with more wrestling skills than Rick Martel. That obviously is why he has the championship belt. But nobody more dangerous than Mr. Saito. You name it, he knows it. Olympic wrestling style, all the martial arts, an Olympic representative of Japan. Plus that, he is just downright mean.
That, perhaps, the biggest understatement around. Saito, a lot of people feel he is a consummate wrestler. He's a former member of the Japanese Olympic team. He has a tremendous amateur background. Very, very huge upper body strength, personified, a master of the martial arts, seemingly there without a weakness.
Saito weighed into this thing, I believe, at 249. I don't know about Martel. Did you get his weight coming in?
Rick Martel tipped the scales at 238 pounds. 11-pound difference in this kind of match, Larry, basically a push.
For all practical purposes, it's a wash. They're both strong. They are both extremely fast. Saito is quick as a cat. There is a difference between quickness and speed, and you'll notice it when you watch Saito. Takes Martel down. Rick bridging him and got a two count.
You're right, Larry. Rick Martel has a great deal of speed. Saito's not that fast, but he is so quick. Cat-like movements.
And again, Rick Martel trying the bridge to get the count. One fall, 60-minute time limit for the heavyweight championship of the world, and you can feel it. There's something about a title match that just sends it through the crowd.
You know, in professional sports, Larry, a lot of times one athlete or another, hockey, football, baseball, basketball, whatever, boxing, wrestling, could have an off night, but not when it's for the heavyweight championship. You know Martel has got to be on the top of his profession. Every time he steps in the ring, it's always against a leading contender. Saito, for him, this is for all the marbles. You know he's ready. Both men will do everything they can to win.
Saito with a shoulder block. Martel about powered out of the arm hold. Saito used here to get the advantage back. Takes him back down to the mat with a headlock. And Saito right back on it. When you feel this kind of tension that you always feel in a championship match, and then you stop and realize that every time Rick Martel walks into a ring, this kind of thing is on the line, you just wonder how long he can hold that title. But he's doing a magnificent job. He's had it for almost a year.
And I'll tell you, everyone associated with professional wrestling, other wrestlers, promoters alike, agree that Rick Martel has gained so much confidence and experience in the 10 months now that he has been world champion. He is going to be one tough champion to beat. And I think when he is beat, Larry, it will probably be because of the tremendous grueling schedule that he has been on. He defends his title all over the world.
Saito coming off with a block. Martel ducking under. They're going fast and furious. Sunset flip. Can he hold him? No. Saito's out of it and right on Martel. Now, there's that quickness we talked about earlier from Saito, and he's right back in control.
A lot of people feel, Larry, that when Rick Martel is beaten, it will just be because he was just plain tired. I don't know how many times I have talked to him or he would have a big title offense one night, have to get on a plane early the next morning, fly sometimes 5-6 hours with just a couple hours of sleep and go back into the ring against yet another top contender. He has defended this all over North America, Chicago, St. Paul, Las Vegas, Winnipeg, Montreal, the biggest cities throughout the world. New York, has been in Japan, the Middle East, Australia, New Zealand. Wherever there's a contender, Rick Martel has defended that title.
Throws the shoulder, trying to get out of the headlock. Takes Saito to the ropes. Can't get through. Saito used the hair. Did Marino see it or not? Apparently not. He's warning Saito, but he didn't see him go to the hair, so the hold stays. Mr. Saito, now there is an excellent shot. See how that forearm right on the ear, squeezing the very oxygen out of the brain of Rick Martel. And look at the upper body strength of Saito. This man is putting it on. Martel jars him, tries the ropes again. Saito got the hair again. Joe Marino saw it this time. They got to break it up. Now Saito goes to those chops. Rick Martel is in trouble.
That he is. Saito, we've talked about, Larry, is a master of the martial arts. But look at Rick Martel up and over. Oh.
Did I say he was in trouble?
Care to change your opinion?
Look at that. Now that's why Rick Martel is the heavyweight champion of the world.
That's what I alluded to earlier, Larry. A lot of wrestlers see Rick Martel, and they make mention of the fact that he has honed the ability to turn a disadvantage to his favor at the single most opportune instant. You saw him immediately turn a big disadvantage right to his advantage.
A very subtle thing here. Martel going to work on the arms. Saito was working on the head. But if Rick Martel can soften up those arms, it's not going to be as easy for Saito to crush his head with those arms. And that is another subtle strategy that a champion will use.
And another reason, Larry, Martel is going after the arms. You know how lethal Saito's chops, judo, and sometimes a karate, I think when the referee's back is turned, how lethal they can be. And if he can weaken those arms, that'll weaken those chops and thrusts as well.
He has the most devastating heart punch that I have ever seen a professional wrestler use. Rick Martel in control, and again, Ken, working on the arms, which is probably the most deadly weapon in Saito's arsenal.
Got to weaken that. We talked earlier about the tremendous upper body strength of Saito, but believe you me, I think Rick Martel is one of the strongest, fastest, most resilient 238-pound men that I have ever seen. And it's about as popular a champion as there has ever been in wrestling.
Well, you look at him and you think he must go somewhere around 245 or 248. Excellent conditioning. There's not an ounce there that doesn't need to be. Now look at Saito. Wonderful camera work. Now look at him.
We take you right inside the ring right here in the major league of professional wrestling.
Look at the strain on Saito's face as Martel turns it on. And now look at Martel put it on. You can hear Saito saying, no, this is his shot. He is not going to give up easily. Martel and Saito. Saito throws out of it, goes into the turnbuckle and gets a steel post on the shoulder. Martel is jarred, but he's going to go right on the attack, right on that arm. That's what he'd been trying to weaken, and Saito helped his cause. Martel cranking it up now. One quick move by Rick Martel, and the whole thing turns around.
Again, we've talked about it. That's why he has held the heavyweight championship of the world for so long.
Well, there's a eye gouge by Saito, and that, of course, is an equalizer. You blind a guy, he has a hard time. If he can't see, he has a terrible time trying to hit you. Now he goes with the chops. He seems to open that up at the very last second and take it just off the throat, just barely legal. And this man is pure power. Throws Martel across the ring. Listen to that. Wham! There's that hard punch.
Look at the camera work. Great camera work by our director, Rick Sharp. Takes you right inside the ring. You can see the devastation that Saito packs into that hard punch.
We talked about it, and he is the most devastating at it. Saito with a sleeper. This could be it for Rick Martel's reign as heavyweight champion of the world. Kenny's got him in the center of the ring.
We've talked about it. Saito was taught this hold by Nick Bockwinkel, and Rick's only hope is that Saito may not have it fully perfected yet, but at this moment it certainly looks like he does. Bockwinkel beginning to drop very close to going down to one knee. He's down to one knee now. This could, as you said, be the beginning of the end.
We've seen Saito have trouble applying this hold before. But it looks like he's got Rick Martel right where he wants him. Look at the concentration on Saito's face.
But yet Martel is still able to hold that one arm straight out, signifying to referee Joe Fiorino he's still conscious, still has his wits about him. Again and again, Saito is able to get his man dazed, but for some reason cannot put him fully out. An ability possessed so well by the likes of Nick Bockwinkel, Greg Gagne, and of course, Vern Gagne.
Now Martel, Kent, what's he got to do? First, get to his feet.
Somehow get the blood back pumping into his brain. What this hole does, it cuts the blood supply off to the carotid artery, and you literally pass out. You actually go to sleep.
He's going to back him into the ropes. That broke it. Saito just can't get that hold right, but he's going right back for it.
Well, now, the one thing, even if Saito is unable to put Martel totally out, it's going to take Rick a while to clear the cobwebs out of his head.
Martel fighting for his title. This is a desperate situation for him. He now is in trouble.
Now take a look, Larry. You can see our camera is picking it up. The eyes of Rick Martel are beginning to get that glazed look like he's on his way to La La Land.
Rick Martel fought so hard to gain this title. He's been such a brilliant champion, and this could be his last hour.
Saito really wants this badly. You know, Rick Martel took the title from Jumbo Tsuruta, another great Japanese wrestler. Saito has a great deal of nationalistic pride, as do all Japanese, and he would like to take that title back to the emperor.
Martel trying to get to his feet. I have never seen someone stay in a sleeper hold this long, and no, Saito, just something is wrong. And Martel, oh,
that's another way to break it. But now you've got to look closely. How fast can Rick Martel regain his senses? He's staggering around right now. Saito, like a cat pursuing him, got to come up behind him.
Oh, look at by Martel off the rope. Martel! Martel! Rick Martel! It looked like all was lost, and now he's right back in control. Listen to that ring shake. And I mean, listen to that ring shake. Martel, pile driver. Here's the cover.
Saito's only hope if he can get that leg over the rope. He was off to the side. And I think that's the only thing that saved him.
Well, he read your mind on that one, and you're right. That's the only thing he could do. Snapping the hamstring now. Rick Martel. Every time he steps into the ring, it's a fight for the most treasured prize in sports.
All the fame, the glory, the money that goes with being the heavyweight champion. Oh, look at this.
Suplex. Saito's done, but can he get three on him? No. Two and a half. And that's not quite good enough. Saito, give it to him. He's one tough customer. Martel going for the suplex again. The whole arena shakes. He covers it. And again, Candy got about two and a half.
I'll tell you, I think part of it, that sleeper, the grueling pace this match is set. Normally, Martel is very quick to hook the leg, but I don't think he's quite as sharp as he normally is. Wait a minute now. Up and over. Oh, he missed. Saito able to roll out of the way.
Rick Martel with his favorite finishing hold, and again, the tide turned. Both men, but it looked like Saito was all but done. Now both men are stunned. Saito first to his feet. Rick Martel, forehead first from over the top rope, and Saito on him with a chop. Flying elbow, and now Saito goes for the cover. No! Rick Martel found it to kick out, and you got to know his subconscious works in this way. Saito with a devastating right back on the neck. Martel looks out of it. Two and a half, that time for Saito.
Boy, I tell you, that was awfully close, Larry. Awfully close.
Less than a second, and Saito would have been the new heavyweight champion of the world. Now look at this. Nobody does that with more power than Mr. Saito. Again, the cover. Two. Oh!
I'll tell you, Larry, I've seen Rick Martel defend his title all over the world, and this is as close as I've seen him come to losing it. Now, wait a minute, Saito going for that scorpion leg lock. If he gets this grip turned over, oh! This could be the end right here. Very few men are able to get out of this one. Martel, Larry, has got to get to the upper push-up position to somehow take the pressure off that lower back area. He cannot use his legs whatsoever. The way Saito's got him wrapped up, it's going to be all upper body and arm strength. That's his only hope.
The crowd going crazy. Rick Martel yelling, my back, and you can believe it. He can feel the heavyweight championship of the world slipping away. I don't know how long he can do this. I didn't think he could stay in there this long. Saito has softened him up with those devastating suplexes. And now Martel trying to drag his way across on that mat. Look at this.
Using the mat cover to try and get to the ropes.
You're never going to see better camera work. Look at the man's face. Look at the determination. Rick Martel dragging himself to those ropes, trying to save the heavyweight championship of the world.
I'll tell you, Larry, it gives you an idea of the pain he's in, because Rick Martel is not a wrestler to use the ropes like he is trying to do, but as we talked about, he will do anything to attain the heavyweight championship.
Joe Furio right there going, what do you say, Rick? Look at this determination. Rick Martel trying with everything he's got. The pressure and the pain. One second. Rick Martel dragging himself and Mr. Saito with him for the hook, and he got him. He got him. Saito thinks he's the champion. Saito right back on him. He thought he had the title, but he didn't. Never dreaming Martel could make the ropes. He may still have the title, but he's in serious trouble. Wait a minute.
Oh, look at this. A flying cross body block.
Three. Rick Martel retains the heavyweight championship of the world.
trying to claim to referee Joe Fiorino that Rick Martel pulled his trunks, but you saw it as we did. No way, that flying cross body block caught Saito, absolutely stunned. Saito thought he had him on the way out. Now you see Martel climbing back into the ring. He wants it. Saito is still. Saito wanting no part of it. Irate heavyweight champion of the world. What a move by Rick Martel. That's the kind of confidence and experience we talked about that Rick Martel has gained in the 10, 11 months here. He has been the heavyweight champion of the world. And listen to this crowd. Oh, how they love Rick Martel.
At least twice in that match, I didn't give him half a chance to hang on to that belt, but there he is. Now watch this. Saito taking Martel. Look, I don't know. I don't know how he did it. In a second, he hit those ropes, turned around, and got the pin.
Pure instinct, Larry. That's why he's heavyweight champion of the world, Ricky Martel.
Still the champion, Rick Martel, in a brilliant move. You're never going to see a better one.